Hi guys. My name is Lotus. In this video I am gonna show you roll forming process and how roll forming machines work. Roll forming, also spelled roll forming, is a type of rolling involving the continuous bending of a long strip of sheet metal, typically coiled steel, into a desired cross section. Roll forming involves uncoiling a long strip of metal and sending it through several stacks of rollers set up in a long line. It is performed at room temperature, hence the moniker coiled, which is often dropped. The basic roll forming machine has a line that can be separated into four major parts. The first part is the entry section, where the material is loaded. The material is usually inserted in sheet form or fed from a continuous coil. The next section, the station rollers, is where the actual roll forming takes place, where the stations are located, and where the metal shapes as it makes its way through the process. Station rollers not only shape the metal, but are the main driving force of the machine. Roll forming machine is the cut-off press, where the metal is cut to a predetermined length. Due to the speed at which the machine works and the fact that it is a continuously working machine, flying die cut-off techniques are not uncommon. It passes through sets of rolls mounted on consecutive stands, each set performing only an incremental part of the bend, until the desired cross-section profile is obtained. Roll forming is ideal for producing constant profile parts with long lengths and in large quantities. Roll forming is, among the manufacturing processes, one of the simplest. Cold roll forming is a method of shaping hard metals, such as steels and stainless steels. The strip is fed through an entry guide to properly align the material as it passes through the rolls of the mill, each set of rolls forming a bend until the material reaches its desired shape. Very precise, complex cross sections can be created, and long lengths of these sections can be consistently reproduced. Along each length, features such as holes, slots, or embosses can easily be added, making the roll forming process a very cost-effective method of achieving a strong, multifunctional shape. Roll sets are typically mounted one over the other on a pair of horizontal parallel shafts supported by a stance. Side rolls and cluster rolls may also be used to provide greater precision and flexibility and to limit stresses on the material. The shaped strips can be cut to length ahead of a roll forming mill, between mills, or at the end of the roll forming line. Roll forming is used instead of extrusion, where the metal required cannot easily be extruded, or where the features along the length of the part are uneconomic to add to an extrusion, or where an extrusion is not accurate enough. Softer metals would probably use extrusion to create similar shapes, but roll forming comes with distinct advantages over extrusion, not least that hard metals such as steels, including duplex steels and stainless steels, can be very accurately formed into complex profiles, and features can be automatically added along the length of those profiles to add functionality. The roll-forming process allows operations such as punching, notching, and welding to be performed in line. The production rate depends greatly on the material thickness and the bend radius. It is, however, also affected by the number of required stations or steps. In some cases, the limiting factor is the punching or cut-off applications. Cutting processes are those in which a piece of sheet metal is separated by applying a great enough force to cause the material to fail. The most common cutting processes are performed by applying a shearing force, and are therefore sometimes referred to as shearing processes. When a great enough shearing force is applied, the shear stress in the material will exceed the ultimate shear strength and the material will fail and separate at the cut location. This shearing force is applied by two tools, one above and one below the sheet. Punching is a cutting process in which material is removed from a piece of sheet metal by applying a great enough shearing force. Punching is very similar to blanking, except that the removed material, called the slug, is scrap and leaves behind the desired internal feature and the sheet, such as a hole or slot. Punching can be used to produce holes and cutouts of various shapes and sizes. The most common punched holes are simple geometric shapes, a circle, square, rectangle, etc., or combinations thereof. The edges of these punched features will have some burst from being sheared but are of fairly good quality. Secondary finishing operations are typically performed to attain smoother edges. The punching process requires a punch press, sheet metal stock, punch, and die. The sheet metal stock is positioned between the punch and die inside the punch press. Advantages of roll forming. Labor cost and time for secondary operations are reduced or eliminated, reducing part costs. Roll form tooling allows for a high degree of flexibility. A single set of roll form tools will make almost any length of the same cross section. Multiple sets of tools for varying length parts are not required. Roll forming can provide better dimensional control than other competing metal forming processes. Repeatability is inherent in the process, allowing easier assembly of roll-formed parts into your finished product, and minimizing problems due to standard tolerance build-up. Roll-forming is typically a higher-speed process. Roll-forming offers customers a superior surface finish. This makes roll-forming an excellent option for decorative stainless steel parts or for parts requiring a finish such as anodizing or powder coating. LOTOSFORMING is professionally for roll-forming machines. The chief engineer has working in roll-forming machine area for more than 20 years. And we have 50 workers in workshop and 8 after-sale service engineers for domestic and overseas customers.